this website first launched, I visited the site with my wife, Tennille, a fourth grade teacher and now literacy coach, but it wasn't until my federal program director's conference last week that I discovered the depth of this site from a colleague in another district. Over lunch, he said to me, "We have access to thousands of free, personalized, individualized resources at our fingertips, and no one knows about it." "Tell me more," I said, and he retrieved his laptop and shared with me over lunch what I want to share with you today. I suspect many, as he claimed, do not know about this resource. How about you? Share your thoughts in the comment section below, either on the Facebook post or on this YouTube video. Now, I am certainly not the most knowledgeable person to be sharing this information, so just consider me a start. TEA has posted a few brief videos on the site, but I've yet to see a walkthrough or a how-to video. Perhaps somebody's already done this already, and if you find it, please share it in the comment sections. In the meantime, here's a quick walkthrough of what I've discovered thus far. To get into the site, you'll need a unique student access code, which comes with students' star results. I have a fake account that'll allow us to explore, so I'm going to log in with the number and the date of birth. And so I'm going to start with the fifth grade reading. So I see my student's score. Now, I don't particularly care for this exact example because this student got a perfect score and, you know, how likely is that? But I can see a couple of things. Test history shows me the test that my child has taken. I can even go so far as click detailed results on the questions that were asked. I can even look at the test questions, the passage, the item, and the rationale for the correct answer. So lots of great resources there, but let's go back to the test results tab. I can see where my student compares in terms of the state, campus, and district average. But what's really cool is this number down here. It's a Lexile measure. Now, a Lexile for a typical fifth grade student is going to be in this green bar here, which looks to be about 800 to 1,000. Now this student, again, got a perfect score and their Lexile is 1,400. And what I can do is down here is find a book tool, and I'll click this explore button. So this will take me to this site, and I'll enter the Lexile number of my child, which we said we're going to use 900, which pre-populates the Lexile range of 850 to 950 automatically to help me find books that are on my student's Lexile measure. So I click submit. Now I also get to choose what my child is interested in. So let's say it's adventure, fantasy, and fiction and literature. I can choose lots and lots of things, but I'll choose submit, and that will pre-populate a list of books that are in my student's Lexile score. Now you can see, you have to look at this through a grain of salt. Here's To Kill a Mockingbird. Is that fifth grade appropriate? Well, typically we read that in high school, but here are these other two. Certainly would be Diary of a Wimpy Kid, The Fault in Our Stars. Now what I can do is either create and add this to my list, or I can find this book on Amazon or even in a library. So if I click that tab, it'll take me to do a search on to the library. But let's go back to my student's results and let's take a look at the test history. And let's look at math this time. Just again, this student is probably not the best example because they had a perfect score. But like before, we can see the test results, compare against the state, campus, and district average, get a few more detailed results, as well as the test questions, the item that was asked, and the rationale to the correct answer. But let's go back to results and scroll down to get that number that's very similar to that Lexile. This is a quantile measure. We can see the grade appropriate quantile here is, looks like maybe 550 to say 800. This particular child's is well above that. So let's just go with, let's say a 750 and say that's our child. I'm gonna hit this explore button, and like I did with the Lexile, that'll take me to another website, and it gives me a little bit of information. But what I wanna find is these quantile tools at home. So I'm gonna click on that. It's going to allow me to choose my state. So I'm gonna scroll down and state, Texas. Then grade level is fifth, and quantile, we said we're going to use, say, 750 for the student. And what that's going to do is it's going to take me to a plethora of web resources. So I can click on any one of these activities that would be appropriate for my child's math ability. I could get to downloadable resources that give me activities that I could do with my child to help build their mathematics ability. And sometimes there are some book and periodical print resources that are available. So a remarkable set of truly free resources to access on the TexasAssessment.com website, which if you will get in and click around and look and search, you can find all kinds of interesting items on there to explore, to examine, to look at. You can choose a possible career for your child and see what Lexile they would need to be successful in that. So lots of really cool stuff. I hope that you will explore the site too, and definitely leave a comment on the comment section of either Facebook or this YouTube video. I look forward to hearing from you and to hear, did you know about this?